morning children, welcome back to English class. Take out your honeycomb. Today we are going to discuss poem The Shell. That is written by Frank Clay. Yes, now I am going to tell you about the author. Frank Clay was not only an author but a doctor and a priest. And his famous books are The Living Heart, Northern Woodway, and Point Smith. So many other books also he has written, and his contribution is not only in writing but also in medicines and in religion. Now just come to the poem The Shed. Children, do you know what a shed is? A shed, firstly, it is an outhouse away from the main home. Main house, that is a shed. A cow shed, a tool shed, a wood shed for example. And it's like a small room. It is used for storing or keeping things, animals, tools, etc. And in this poem, the poet is going to tell you about the shed. That is in his garden. Come to the first stanza. Now we are going to read the poem. Yes, first stanza. There is a shed at the bottom of our garden with a spider's web hanging across the door. The hinges are rusty and creak in the wind. When I am in bed, I lie and I listen. I will open that door. Now the poet, I means the poet, the narrator himself, he is telling us his experience. There is a shed at the bottom of our garden. What the poet wants to say in first stanza? That there is a shed at the bottom. Bottom means at the end of his garden with a spider's web hanging across the door. And its doors are covered with spider webs. What it indicates? Spider webs means nobody is taking care of that house. The hinges are rusty and creak in the wind. Hinges. What do you mean by hinges? Joints in door that helps it to open or close. Hinges are joints that are in doors and help the door to open or close. Next is rusty. Rusty means faded or discolored. The things which we don't take care, they become rusty. And their insects like spiders, they make their webs also. And creak in the wind. When we open the door, when the poet opens the door, then it makes creak sound. Creak means to make sharp and unpleasant sound. When I am in bed I lie and I listen. When I rest in my bed, when I sleep, I listen to these unpleasant sounds. I will open that door one day. But the poet is confident that he will surely open that door of the shed one day. So in the first stanza you have seen the spider's web, rusty, creak, all these words. What they indicate? They tell us about the neglected state of the house. Means nobody is taking care of that rusty house or the shed. Come to second stanza now. There is a dusty old window around at the side with three cracked panes of glass. I often think there is someone staring at me each time that I pass. I will peek through that window one day. Now in the second stanza, the poet is stressing on the description of the shed he is describing. There cracked panes of glass. What do you mean by panes? Panes means the glass sheets. Yes, there are three window panes that are cracked, broken. I often think there is someone staring at me. And whenever the poet passes through that house, what he feels? That there is somebody inside the house and staring at him. Staring means to look at somebody for a long time, or it means poorna. There to create a feeling of fear. What he feels like whenever he passes through that house? That there is somebody that is staring at him. Each time that I pass, I will peek through that window one day. But still, he wishes, he was curious to know who was in the house, that he will check one day. He will peek. What do you mean by peek? Peek means to look inside through a hole. So what the poet wants to know? Who is there in the house? Come to third sentence now. My brother says there is a ghost in the shed who hides under the rotten floorboards, and if I ever dare to set foot inside, he will jump out and chop off my head. But I will take a peek one day. Yes, in the third sentence, but the poet wants to say that his brother, my brother means the poet's brother, his brother says there is a ghost in the shed. His brother says that there is in the outhouse there is a ghost who hides under the rotten floorboards, and he is hiding in the floorboards of that shed. Rotten means a place that has become decayed. And if I ever dare to set foot inside, and if the poet will try to go inside that shed, he will jump out. Who is he here? The ghost. The ghost will jump out, means attack on him and chop off my head. What do you mean by chop? To cut something into pieces. Now the poet's brother is again terrifying him. There are echoes. What is he saying? That there is a ghost in the shed who is hiding under the rotten floor, and if the poet will try to go inside the shed, he will attack on him and cut off his head. But I will take a peek one day. But still, the poet is confident, curious, excited to know that what is inside that shed. Now come to fourth and last stanza. I know that there is not really a ghost. My brother tells lies to keep the shed for his den. There isn't anyone staring or making strange noises. And the spider has been gone from his web. Since I don't know when, I will go into that shed one day soon, but not just yet, but not just yet. So in the last chapter, what the poet is describing, I know that there is not really a ghost. Means up to the last chapter, the poet has grown up, his understanding has now make him a mature person, and he now understands that ghosts are not real, these are imaginary things. He knows now that there is no ghost there. My brother tells lies. His brother is telling lies. Iska brother kya kar raha hai? Jhoot bol raha hai. His brother tells lies to keep the shed for his den. What his brother wants? To keep that shed for his private work. There isn't anyone staring or making strange noises. What the poet is now understanding? That there is no one inside the shed. No one that is looking at me, staring at me. And now there are no strange noises. rusty doors. And the spider has been gone from his web. Even now the spiders are not there. Since I don't know where, I will go into their shed one day soon. And what he says, that now I am not afraid of, now I am not fearful, I am sure there is nobody in the house, in that shed, and I will surely go there one day, but not just yet. But he says that he will surely go one day into that shed, but not just now. Now in these four stanzas, you have seen that there are mixed feelings of the poet. The horrific looks of the shed. Horrific looks means जो ड्रैगन्स की लुक है, दैट इज एन आइसोलेटेड प्लेस, देर इज नोबडी टेकिंग केयर ऑफ दैट हाउस एंड दैट गिव्स हॉरिफिक लुक्स. द हॉरिफिक लुक्स ऑफ द शेड रिपेल्ड हिम फ्रॉम एंटरिंग द शेड. उसको रोक रहे हैं, रिपेल हिम स्टॉपिंग हिम फ्रॉम एंटरिंग, गोइंग इनसाइड द शेड. द रस्टी एंड द डस्टी विंडोज. द रस्टी विंडोज आई हैव टोल्ड यू व्हिच आर फेडेड एंड डिसकलर. And also the dusty windows full of dust and dirt. Broken window panes. There are windows whose panes are broken. Spiders live in every corner of the house. Scary stories of presence of ghosts told by his brother. That have scared the poet. The poet is little bit afraid, fearful to go inside the shed. But yet he promises to himself that he will visit the shed one day. Surely he will visit the shed in the coming years, but not now. Now, children, I think this poem is very short, but still having the main idea that we shouldn't get feared from the things without knowing.